So someone will call us risky, but I think if you don't take risk, you also take risk. The team we started this game with was David Ryan goal, Ethan Pinnock, Pontus Jansson, Christopher Ayer in the back three, Sergi Canós and Rico Henry in the two wingbacks, Christian Nørgaard as a six, Franco Nieka and Vitali Janelt as a 2-8, and then it had Brian Mbeumo and Ivan Toney on top. The reason why we set the team up like this was that we wanted to carry on from the season before with the back three, because we think that's a big help for us in terms of defend well. And we think the team is better with a back three, back five, when we need that sometimes. Going into a league that we know is maybe the toughest league in the world, and you know you need to be able to defend well. So that's why we kept that, and we had the three midfielders we also had from last season in terms of, we think that gave us a big stability. We also have two willing runners in the eights that can run around the two strikers, and then two strikers that look very, very strong together. So that's why I want, in general, in games to, you know, to be able to switch between this system, 3-5-2, and let's say a 3-4-3. So that's something we've been practicing quite a lot, to be able to do both. And we were closer and closer to do it this season, and unfortunately Johan Wissen got injured. And I also play around with a more offensive plan B solution, where we have two sitters at 10 and two strikers when we do that. So just to have different tools to play around with during a game, depending on the momentum, the score, and the team I'm in charge of. Two things I knew that could be very big for us in this game was our out of possession work, and that was our mindset and setup in terms of high pressure, especially middle to high pressure. The more aggressive we could be, the more forward pressing we could be, the better. That was the one thing, and the second thing was set pieces. I was sure that we would be stronger than Arsenal on set pieces. So if you go through the out of position scenarios, then Arsenal, they set up in this 4-2-3-1 or 4-4-2, depending on how you see it, especially when they defend. But they change it slightly when they attack, and it's more set. So we knew that they will put Tierney high as a wing back. They will keep Pepe to the right, also high. Then they will have Chambers in this game, White and Mari as the three centre backs, and then they had Lugonka and Xhaka as the two sitters, and then Smith-Rowe, you know, were a little bit as a 10 up here, and Martinelli was a little bit as a 10 up here, and then we had Balogun as their number 9. So in that transition, we knew the more it's possible, especially in the high pressure, I like to go a little bit more man-man. Because if you go a little bit in between, these teams are too good. They just find the pass in between the player around you, if you're high up the pitch. If you're lower, it's different. That's where we make it a little bit more compact. So we need to find the right balance between that. Again, if we get the two strikers to do something like this in these situations, and then they were able to play all the way down to Leno, and then they played to Chambers. It was very important that our outside eight, in this case, Vitali Janelt, released early and put the pressure, and we were brave enough, you know, to really, really be front-footed and really brave. And can we lose a duel here? Yes, we can sometimes, but I still believe it's so difficult in the right moment, and if we press with the right intensity, that we were able to do that. Another thing where we knew where they will try to build, where with in their goal kicks, again, my approach is the more we can go man-man these scenarios, the better. It's not, you know, it's always a little bit tricky depending on where the strikers are. But we put Chambers were a little bit low, put Vitali Janelt a little bit higher. We had Nørgaard and Franco Nieka in here, Sergi marking Tierney. And then it was a little bit of scenario like this. And then if they wanted to play, of course, we know they have a keeper that is relatively good with his feet. So the more we either could cut the line to the keeper, or in this case, you know, the other striker coming in, and then again, as you can see here, then we still have that little bit extra, you know, in these situations if we can, and then we have forced it to one side and very, very man orientated. Of course, if it goes like this, no reason he stands there, then I still have that man-man zonal approach. So we overload these areas, and if they go longer from here, then he can still double up in these situations. But extremely aggressive, intense in these scenarios. And that way we created quite a few dangerous situations. In possession in the game against Arsenal, we tried to find the areas where we could potentially explore Arsenal's weaknesses. In general, I like to create local supremacy. So we have, you know, 3 versus 2 or 4 versus 3 in different areas. I think especially a big thing for us this game were that if we play with wingbacks, it's very difficult for a back four from Arsenal to cover the width. And in these scenarios where you also have that scenario where we have the outside centre back and we have our wing back, so if they go early, then their centre back need to come out either to be with a striker, or that run down the channel here for our 8 is a very difficult and tricky situations for Arsenal to take care of. Because now we can create an overload in these situations, or again, you know, it's difficult to cover everything the other side of the pitch. So some of the scenarios was definitely use that space, I would call that space on the outside here, to explore. And then very in general for me, as a principle, not only for this game, the more we can hurt that half space we're talking about a lot, the better. And it's maybe not, you know, we play and we run down there and then we have a clear, beautiful pass under the line and a goal. Then it's more, we get dragged the centre backs a little bit out of possession. We can combine a little bit again. And then we have a scenario where we maybe potentially have 3v2 at the back stick. So can we produce a situation where we can produce a cross here, where we also have dragged the centre back out? Then we have a very, very positive situation when we try to attack. I remember this game that I would have loved us to be even more brave on the ball in this game, throughout the game. I felt we were extremely brave when we were pressing high. On the ball, I felt we were good, but I felt we could have been even better. But okay, we went up 1-0 after 20 minutes. You want something to hang on to, very aware of defending well. But that was, luckily enough, something that we have progressed and got better and better to. After we decided to go to this 3-5-2 system, one of the big reasons were that we wanted at least one of our wingbacks to be more offensive minded. So Sergi Canós, that is a winger of trade, he needed a little bit of convincing that he had to play that role. But fair play to him, you know, he's just been very open-minded, very positive about his role, playing to the left in the back end of last season in Championship, and now playing to the right because Rico Henry is fit and ready to go. Because when you play with 3 centre back, for me, it can be a little bit too stiff and mechanic if you don't have very offensive wing backs. And that's why I really like to have a winger, a Sergi, with his offensive qualities, technical abilities, you know, the composure, taking care of the ball, but also the abilities on crossing, finishing, one-on-one situations. And I think Sergi in the Arsenal game played a fantastic game, defended like a beast, and on the ball, of course, produced a beautiful goal, produced a lot of good one-on-one situations, and were a constant threat. And I think that's what you get by playing a winger in a wing-back position. So in general, I try to get as many offensive players into each position because I believe that gives us a bigger chance of winning the game. The first goal, I can't remember how many on the last line, but it was something after a set piece that was cleared back to David in that case here. When he got it here, especially with his abilities on the ball, we are very aware that we keep either the striker Ivan Toney to the side or one of the center backs drop to the side. And then instead of start playing because everyone is getting up, then we play a longer ball to the side, either side, but the side where we have the best mismatch. And from there, Ethan Pinnock, our center back, won the ball, a duel, and it created a little bit of chaos down here. And after a couple of clearances, Sergi Canós picked up the ball in that situation and were dribbling in towards in the middle of the pitch and were finishing through the leg of Champas. So no reaction time for Leno in that situation. So it, you can say a lot of things in football are random, but the first bit was not random. It's part of when I go back to David, we try to overload the sides with two players either side, and that's where you can drop it down there and then we can keep it up here and keep the pressure. That was the first goal. In general, we know, and that's also one of the reasons why we play with a front two. I think the two strikers we have in Ivan Toney and Brian Obuemo, they complement each other fantastic. We prefer if we can dominate the ball on the floor, and that's where I think we are best when that's possible. I like flexibility. I also think the best teams, they have more weapons, so we can, you know, create through the lines, but also when needed, we can go longer, and that's very difficult to defend a longer ball for Ivan Toney that either link it up and play around with our two eights in these scenarios, or we have Brian Obuemo who's running through and going deep in these situations. Our second goal was a set piece long throw. We knew we were stronger than Arsenal, and we had three players overloading the front area, and then we have two, you know, that were going on to the flick. And when, if someone is going to watch that goal back, in this case it was Mads Beck Sørensen who's taking the long throw, and no one actually touches it, actually ending bouncing in the six-yard box and jumping in here. And then we actually have two Brentford players in front of each other, almost taking each other out just to get it into the back of the net, because they just overran the two Arsenal players. Because it's difficult to defend in these situations because someone's running forward, but they did that very well. What I like us, what we do as well, is that we have everyone up. So we are very offensive minded in these situations. So someone will call us risky, but I think if you don't take risk, you also take risk. So I think it's important that you know it's a risk reward. And we also have a high line with our goalkeeper, David. But in general, if we do this, we have a much better chance of keeping the ball up here. And that second phase can create more dangerous situations for us in the box. So that's why we have that approach. The thing we learned from the Arsenal game were that we got a bit more confidence, that we could be an asset to the Premier League, that we could actually hopefully belong in this league for a long time. I told the players before the game that I had a massive belief in them. And the week going up to the Arsenal game, I said, I'm going into this game with a feeling that I'll be very disappointed if we lose it. And that's, you know, a promoted team going in to play one of the biggest clubs in the world. But I just knew what these players are capable of. I've, you know, known them for, some of them for almost 5 years. some of them at least 2 years. And it's a fantastic group of players. And I think we also showed that, especially in this game against Arsenal, okay, we can compete. We know it's a very long season, but if we are brave, we have a good mindset, keep doing it the way we want to do it, press as high as possible, try to dominate as much as possible on the ball, then I think we have a good chance.